about a senior head instructor.
Thank you, sir. About a third degree black sash and beginner students in front. Again, do some deep breath and relaxation. Sort of settle the body, settle the mind. Allow the eyes to close. You can think of this as adding water to the plate. A little softer, a little more receptive to feeling correct alignment. Just relaxing into correct alignment. The eyes closed. Soften the eyes. Release any tension around brow, jaw, lips. Breathe in, feel your lower abdomen expand. Don't force it, just see if you can notice it go out a little bit when you breathe in, and relax back in when you breathe out. To imagine the cascade of relaxation flowing down the body, starting from the top of the head, flowing down to the bottoms of the feet. Relax the neck, the upper back and chest. Cascade continue to the shoulders, to arms and hands. Relax the stomach. Relax the lower back. Feel the waist loosen. Feel the hips relax. Relax thighs, backs of the legs, the knees and the backs of the knees. Feel the calves relax. Feel around the shin bone relax. Relax the ankles. More breaths, see if you can feel or experience with complete clarity the feelings of the bottoms of the feet, all the sensation, the details of the sock and the shoe on your back. The tile floor and the sock. Down towards the center of the earth. With your next exhale, release, lowering hands up the back. Separate the feet to shoulder width if they're not already there. Embracing horse. Turn the toes in, outside edges parallel. Bend the knees, round the knees out. Tuck the pelvis under. Circle the arms forward. About 3 minutes from now. So if you find yourself straining to be in the posture, go ahead and come out of it, reset, get back into it. beyond that, you feel the whole body relaxed downward from it. The idea is you feel like your body is suspended from above. Let everything relax. Make sure nothing's tense from the body. Circle the arms up, breathe in. Push palms down, breathe out. Okay. Let's go from the top one time, and then we'll take a look at that brush and push section again and see what the next thing we need is.
Sir.
Crane squares, brush knee push one. Playing guitar one. Brush knee push two. Brush knee push three. Brush knee push four. I think we worked on pretty extensively last class. Unless I skipped it. Playing guitar two. Brush knee push five, just like the second one. Very good, very good. So I think what we should do at this point is take a look at the next move. Who's here? There's one student missing right now. And so that means we'll probably come back and review this. So we're gonna push ahead a little bit, realizing that we'll probably go back and fill in a lot of details that maybe aren't quite so clear yet on some of the previous ones. But before we do that, are there any questions that you have that I can maybe clear up before we go to the next move? Because sometimes having a question about one move makes it hard to soak in the next one. The mind won't let it go. Are there any questions like that?
That's right.
Okay, cool. So the next move after the brush knee push section is called hidden hand punch. It's also called step forward, deflect downward, intercept and punch, but we're gonna stick with the shorter one. You'll see it does all these things, but we'll just call it hidden hand punch. Hidden, I don't speak clearly, H-I-D-D-E-N, hand punch. So we will start from the end of the last brush knee push. So face the mirror, there you go. Get to your shoulder width. We're gonna put our feet in double dragons arrangement. Turn the right foot out 45 degrees, step the left foot straight forward. It's kind of like a walking step. And then shift into that small lunge. The hips will pretty much face forward. Left hand down by the knee, right hand out. Like you're pushing the right hand. Hold there, make sure we have a good starting position. This next move can seem complicated, but it'll make more sense. First, you shift back, lean forward a little bit, and make a fist in the right hand. Because I shifted back, my toe came up. I'm not trying to pick it up with my muscles. It just came back. Turn to the left, pivot on the heel. Shift to the left, and feel the right heel release. And stay kind of sunk down and step in. Good. Step out to a T, meaning if I brought my foot back, you would make a T with the other one. Shift to the right. Turn left and lift the hands into a T. It's still kind of arranged like they were, so the right hand is still being fixed. Good. Turn to the right, release the left heel. Step in, feel your balance, step out, heel toe. Again to that same foot placement, double dragons. Shift forward and let the hips turn from the right back to the center and punch under the left hand. Do that a couple more times. See how close you can get on the starting position on your own. So again, shift back, lean forward, make a fist in the right. Turn to the left, pivot on the heel. Shift to the left, release the right heel. Sink down, step in. Step out to a T, heel toe. Shift to the right, turn to the left. Lift the hands into a T. Good. Turn to the right, release the left heel. Step in. Step out, heel toe. Shift forward. Good. Turn a little punch forward. Hidden hand punch. Good. One more time. Turn to the right, release the left heel. Step in. Step up. Heel toe. Shift. Forward. Turn. Straighten out. And release. All right, cool. So I'll demonstrate first and we'll see if you have questions. So I'll flip it around so you can see whatever was hidden by my body the other way. Questions, or do you want to see it again? Yes, sir.
Just one more time.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Definitely. Did you have questions?
Yeah. Well, I'm a nitpick there. So when you, how straight are you when you turn here? Are you, like?
Straight.
Like, I'm kind of, want to lean, but is it just like?
Okay, yeah. So, how would I say that? It's a good question. So, from here to the top. top of the head, I want to go pretty straight. Then the arms are kind of like they work down. Then if you just turn from the waist and cut them together, be like that. So,
so you're turning as far as it is before you start to.
Before the hip starts to come out. Did that make sense? Yeah, I saw you do it. It made more sense. So, yeah. So if I turn farther than this knee starts to come in, I start to turn in other parts of the body.
So you don't really necessarily need to sink, you just turn as far as you need to.
Yeah.
Okay.
And the shift to the right will enable more of a turn to the left. So this is, you know, one of those, this smooth specifically seems weirder when it's broken down than when you smooth it out. Because when you learn to do it quickly, you know, it'll smooth out into a different way, right? And one thing we're doing is we're making sure to learn to turn our body on this part, because the windup in the body is so important for the power of the move, and it can get sort of, if I just showed you the final version, it would sort of get lost. Does that make sense?
I see the windup now. I didn't see the windup before.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, you're winding up the.
Yes, ma'am, exactly. Yeah. I'm shifting my weight, I'm winding up, and then with all that power in my body, I'm going to be deflecting attack downward and then attacking as well. That's a good question.
Cool.
And do you want to see it again, sir?
Yes.
I'll do a little more. It is a vertical punch, so we're used to seeing punches that turn over. This is just a different kind. The knuckles if you're horizontal, and the body, right? And also, it's also like not all the way out. We get to relax the shoulder and elbow a little bit. All right. Any other questions? Let's practice it, and then I'll talk about it. Again, with instruction, shift back, lean forward, form that fist, right, turn the left hip on the floor. Good, shift to the left, your knees to the right heel, step in, step out, heel toe, T, shift, feel your weight shift, and feel your body turn, and make the other T, good, yeah, turn to the right, release the left heel, step in, step out, heel toe, shift forward. At the end, feel, you know, front leg bent, back leg fairly straight, 60% of your weight in the front leg. Let's do it again, and then I'll come around for some specific corrections. So this will start and stop on this back. Shift back, make a fist, lean forward. Good. Turn to the left, to go here. Shift to the left, release the right heel, sink down, step in. Step out. Shift to the right, turn to the left, look, and hold here. Okay, this is correct. Feel a little closer together, but yeah, correct. This is good. Shift to the left, to the right. That's good. That's good. Yeah, it's so good. Okay. Good. Good. Turn to the right, release the left heel. And you can almost imagine like you're drawing a bow back in the right hand. Your leg is kind of pulling back. Sink down, step in. Step out, heel toe, double dragons. Shift forward. And punch. Hold here one more time. Take it out a little bit, take a few breaths. Incidentally, the reason it's called hidden hand punch is when we learn the application, and we're able to do that again, if you imagine a punch coming in, I deflect it downward, and the opponent's kind of turned, and I'm touching their arm, and I actually come in with the punch under the ribs, under their arm. So if done correctly, you don't see it coming. And if anyone knows how that works. The ones that you don't see coming are the ones that really get you when you're not doing that reaction that you just a little bit, you know. Let's do this. Weird. The simple explanations of just showing it happen are turned into many words. But shift back and forward. Good. Turn to the left. Good. Shift to the left, release the right. Step in. Step out. Shift. Turn. Make the T. Turn to the right. Release the left. Okay, so we'll do it a couple more times. I'm going to stop saying all the details, but we'll go at the same speed, so see if you can still remember all those parts. Hit in hand, punch, begin. Reset and when you, reset, let's do it one more time. Actually, follow, leaving it one time.
Sure.
Yeah.
Here or there?
Pardon?
You want to go up there? Or
actually, probably right there is totally fine. Just keep it consistent. Okay. If you're watching at home, just try it on your own. And begin. Any other questions on that one? this is one especially where I think you can see like, oh, Tai Chi is going to smooth all these together. So every point where I stop is in the end not going to be a stop, right? There's going to be a smooth transition between them all. So I know y'all are moving like me because that's what I just taught. Just keep in mind that it'll be those will really be stopping points, and then you'll learn, oh, look, there's no stopping points in the whole form until you hit here. Okay, cool. Let's go from the top one more time. So we'll do all those moves we did before, and let's connect it to the new one today. Take a few more deep breaths, feel the hands relax by the sides. Yeah, step one. And this. Three. Yeah, ward off breath. Ward off breath. Ward off breath. Pull back and press. Push. Single wing. Lift hand. Light crane spread. Brush knee push one. Playing guitar one. Brush knee push two. two. Brush knee push, five. Okay, what we did today, get your best hidden hand punch. Just to give you a sense of scale, from here to the end, we have withdraw and push, cross hands. So we are right at the end, which you would expect at the end of the unit. So it worked out. And then what we do is at the end of the unit, which I guess is after next week, I'm looking at you guys, thank you. Then we will either start over at the beginning of this whole section again, or we will cover the other thing, which is NACOM and 10 foundation postures. So,
there we go.
Any last questions, comments, suggestions? All right, great work. Let's do our bow out with our five parts. Follow the five parts:
faith, respect, perseverance, patience, and humility.
About a senior head instructor.
Thank you, sir. About a third degree black sash and beginner student and newcomer.